every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to succeed.
Well, grace and peace. Good morning to each and every one of you. Welcome to Fresh Start. This is Pastor Daryl Fair, of course, and I am eager to begin this brand new day with each and every one of you. I trust that you've had time to fellowship there in the chat area and grab your Bible and grab something to write with and something to write on as we are preparing to go into our morning scripture. Let me remind you of our foundational scripture for this entire morning devotion. It is found in Lamentations chapter number 3 and verse number 23, where the Bible says that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is his faithfulness to you and I. Every day we wake up is a day that we know that God has given us his grace and his mercy, and that he has been faithful to us once again to extend to us that so needed of a tool and principle of grace and mercy. And indeed, he's given us a fresh start on today. I want you to grab your Bibles and go with me to 1 Corinthians chapter number 15 and in verse number 58. Somewhat familiar to us, but I want to challenge us and encourage us this morning with something that I think might be a blessing to you. And excuse my voice. So I think since the last time I've been sick, I can't shake this raspy and this a little cough or what have you. But I want to show you a verse of scripture in 1 Corinthians chapter number 15, verse 58. King James says, "Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast and unmovable." You see it underlined there. So you know that's going to be our focus. "Be steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord." Let me begin by suggesting that this particular passage of scripture that we see here, and I'm trying to put it back up on the screen so I can maneuver just a bit. But this particular passage of scripture that we just read, I share often that when I'm teaching ministers to understand a particular verse of scripture, sometimes it's best to work backwards to get a better understanding of that particular passage of scripture. Don't want to necessarily work totally backwards, but I want to point out something that's in this particular passage here, where he says, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for your labor is not in vain in the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Now, he tells us to be something. And then he says, so that we are always abounding. That word abounding there literally means to go beyond a set number, to go beyond a set number. In other words, go beyond what was previously established for you. Then he says, you know, the always abounding in the work of the Lord. So that which God has called you and I to do should always be moving in a trajectory that requires that we keep moving, but not only moving, but that we are being more effective as we go, not less effective, but more effective in the thing that God has called us into. And there's a lot here. And for the sake of time, maybe we'll spend a couple of days here. And then I think we'll be in Romans chapter number 8 in a couple of days from now, if not tomorrow. But there's something here that I want us to look at. He says, therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast and unmovable. Steadfast and unmovable. One of the things that I want to make sure that we look at in this particular passage of scripture is that the word steadfast, the root definition means to be seated, to be seated. Steadfast, the root definition means to be seated. And the idea is that you are positioned in a certain place, and there is a resolve to stay there. Now, be steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. So where God has me, what God has graced me to do, I am to abound in that particular area. But one of the things that Paul says is, he says, to be steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For that to occur, I have to know what moves me. I have to know what are the things that stop me, hinder me, block me from doing what God has called me to do. And here's our fresh focus. I know we haven't had one in quite some time, but here's our fresh focus for this morning. I want you to consider something today. How do you handle the things that move you, not motivate you, but the things that move you, stop you, hinder you, cause you not to do what God has assigned or positioned you to do? How do you handle those things? Because Paul writes and says that we need to be unmovable. And for that to happen, I need to be seated, positioned, stationary, sedentary is another word that is used in the definition. For me to do that, I have to be aware of the things that might cause me not to be seated, not to be still, not to be focused, not to persevere and to be persistent. What are those things that cause you to stop in what you know God's called you to do? Scripture says one time, he says, be steadfast and unmovable. It talks about making sure that we're pressing ahead and making sure that we're reaching for those things which are before us. I am going to stop there for this morning because I'm way out of time, but I want you to consider that this morning and throughout the day. What stops you from doing what God has called you to do? What is it that unnerves you? What is it that bothers you so that you stop doing what God has anointed, graced, and purposed for you to do? Because it is that thing that Paul says, be steadfast and unmovable. So how do you handle the things that move you? Consider that, pray about that, list those things in your own private time, and the Lord say the same. I will see you in the morning as we continue to build our faith as we travel through God's word. God bless you. I'll see you in the morning. The gospel, this is the good news.